how do I reconstitute a protein? This is a common question that we get from our customers. I'm Paige, I'm a senior research scientist at Future Fields, and I'm gonna show you our recommended process for reconstituting your lyophilized product. You're going to need a diluent, a syringe, a needle, your lyophilized product, and a container to dispense your product into. First, you're gonna remove the plastic cap from your vial and gently tap down any loose powder on the sides. Connect your syringe to your needle. Next, we're going to draw up the volume of diluent we need using our syringe, depending on the size of your vial. I need 750 microliters because I have a 750 microgram vial and I want to make a 1 mg/mL solution. Refer to your product data sheet for your specific product to determine your dilution ratio. It can be found in the reconstitution section. Insert the needle into the rubber stopper of the vial without touching the lyophilized product. Dispense the liquid into the vial without forcing it into the vial. If you need to, allow air to come back up into the syringe to equalize the pressure and slowly work the liquid into the vial. Once you've dispensed all your liquid, fill your syringe with air that is approximately equal to the amount of liquid you dispensed to equalize the pressure, and then remove your needle. Follow the product-specific instructions for reconstitution. Some products will require a longer incubation time or specific mixing protocols. For most products, gently swirling the vial while avoiding foam is sufficient. Draw air into the syringe equal to the amount of protein you're going to remove from the vial. I'm gonna remove all of it, so I'm gonna use 750 microliters. Insert the syringe into the cap of your vial again. Dispense the air into the vial to displace the liquid, and then you can draw up the liquid out of the vial. And you can remove the needle, and then we're going to dispense this into whatever container we want our protein to be in. And that's it. Be sure to follow your institution's policies for safe handling of needles and discard the needle in a proper sharps container. Once you finish working with your protein, you can store it for up to 3 months at minus 20 or whatever is recommended on your product specific data sheet. If you have any questions, you can reach out to us at support@futurefields.io, and good luck with your research.